Good afternoon and welcome to Spielberg, and to a circuit that in one form or another has held every Austrian Grand Prix in the championship, except the very first back in 1964. It was at this race that John Watson lost a bet and his beard when he took Team Penske's only F1 victory in 1976. If anything, the stakes are even higher today, with 25 points available for victory and a crucial advantage in the championship fight. It's a short lap here in Spielberg with just 10 corners, 7 rights and 3 lefts, making up the total distance of 2.6 miles. And expect to see a lot of cars running wide today, especially through the last corner, as the wet conditions make the cars skittish through the downhill sections. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Alexander Albon will lead us away from pole position, and it's Pierre Gasly in P2. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Perez, Mr. Monaco. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. And Magnussen, Hülkenberg, Butler, Weber, and Lewis Hamilton, Bottas, Russell, Lando Norris, and Sainz, Raikkonen, Verstappen, Daniel Ricciardo, and Antonio Giovinazzi. Vettel and Daniel Kvyat completes the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
We're not starting where we wanted. We'll need to fight our way up the grid today. Okay, the boots aren't looking too worn at this point. We should have plenty of life left in them. Let's make sure we keep managing them properly. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch. inters are faster, we're right on the crossover.
Certain which is the best tyre right now, dries or inters.
practice lap. Only one stop to go. One stop left in this strategy. The pit window is open. Pit window currently open. Confirmed. We'll receive you at the end of this lap. Stopping this lap. Affirmative. Medium tyres at the next stop. Okay, we can take you this lap. Seconds. Okay, we need some energy harvesting. Reduce ERS deployment. P6, we have P6. Buckler is ahead of you. Our gap to the car in front is 2.1 seconds. They're on fresh softs. Hulkenberg behind. Our gap behind is 5.9 seconds. They're on fresh softs. The gap to the leader is 6.6 seconds. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. 7 laps to go. Let's try to keep mileage on it to a minimum. Fuel target is +1. Faster engine modes are available. Laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. You're taking 2.5 seconds out of them each lap. Good job, mate. Really well done. That was a fantastic drive.
A beautiful performance from McLaren today. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs. And that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
Our drivers are making their way out for the podium celebrations, and it's going to be McLaren picking up the winner's trophy. Congratulations to the entire team for that fantastic performance. So let's review the updated driver standings. Despite the best efforts of our championship leader, that lead has taken a bit of a knock today after an incredible day of racing. Who was your driver of the day, Ant?
I mean, can it be anyone else other than Danny Kvyat? His performance today really set him apart from the other drivers out there. He's got to be happy with how he's done here this weekend.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. The current championship leaders still hold top spot, but that gap is getting smaller. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. Well, that was certainly an incredible weekend of racing. Be sure to join myself and Ant for more exciting Formula One action soon.